Yes, Serum can sound analog, and I'm going to show you how in 3 easy steps. X1st Serum needs no introduction. I mean, in my book, it's by far the best synth plugin ever made. But it has always been associated with EDM, dubstep, and stuff like that. The fact is, it is capable of much more than that. And to make it sound more analog, I have 3 things that I apply on pretty much all my retro sound. Choosing the right waveform and filter, adding imperfections, and keeping it simple. Let's apply these tricks while designing a sound. Let's go. Choosing the right waveform is crucial. And if you can, adding your own analog wavetable would be even better, sampled from like old school hardware synthesizers. To start our sound, we're gonna choose the analog section for the first oscillator, obviously, and we're gonna go to the JNO waveform. I really like this waveform for analog type of sound. We're gonna do the same thing for oscillator A and oscillator B. And then we're going to turn up the release. Just like that. Analog synths possess certain irregularities and inconsistencies, like filter instabilities, slight detuning, and subtle pitch modulation. So this is the most important part to add imperfection. In my book, this is what creates the whole analog feel. First, we're going to detune the second oscillator just a bit. Not too much, just like that. Then I'm going to take LFO1, assign it to the pitch of the first oscillator. I'm going to hold Alt and Shift and left click. And then I'm going to turn it down to 1. I'm going to do the same thing for the second oscillator. Just like that. And then I'm going to turn it down a bit. Make it a bit more faster. It's already much better. Then what I like to do is go to the matrix section. I'm going to choose the Chaos 1, assign it to the master tune, and then turn it up to 1 just a little. And then I'm going to turn up the rate just right there and activate the BPM sync. So this is a bit too much, so we're gonna turn it down just like that. And finally, we're going to activate the filter. We're gonna choose the MG Low 24. I'm taking the envelope 2, assign it to the cutoff, activate both oscillator. And take the macro 1, assign it also to the cutoff. And maybe add a bit of noise. I like the ARP pink for analog type of sound. This one might be obvious for some of you guys, but while wavetable modulation is a powerful tool, limiting extreme modulation or FXs can help maintain a more analog feel. Finally, to finish up our sound, we're gonna go to the FX section and add reverb, delay, stuff like that. But not too much, keep it simple. Thank you. maybe a bit of chorus, not too much. Then what I like to do to finish up my sound, I like to assign the velocity to the cutoff. That's perfect. So this is our final sound. Remember that you can use these techniques on pretty much any sound. Have fun. Thanks for watching. Ciao.